Assume you are just shown a regression y is equal to beta 0, beta 1, x1 plus epsilon, and are asked whether the OLS estimator is a consistent estimator of beta 1. You cannot really answer. It depends on what this beta 1 shall be. If it is defined as the coefficient of the best linear predictor, beta 1 star, then OLS estimator is probably a consistent estimate of it. Some weak assumptions have to be satisfied, but often that's the case. However, if beta 1 is defined as a particular causal effect of x1 on y, then it's not so clear. And for example, our simulation example, this causal effect was different than the coefficient of the best linear predictor. And so our OLS estimator would be an inconsistent estimator of beta 1. It really depends on what we mean by beta 1. And just looking at the regression equation, we don't really see so much what this beta 1 shall mean. So typically, this is described verbally in some research paper. And some papers sometimes don't really make it perfectly clear what they mean. What is also very helpful is to draw a causal graph to understand what you mean. We have already introduced such graphs in chapter 1. Here I'm going back. That was an example for estimating the returns to education. So what's the causal effect of a university degree on your wage? And for example, here was the question, did we want to estimate, should the coefficient in front of the university degree measure the complete causal effect or maybe only the causal effect that is not through the channel that getting a degree increases the probability to be in a management position. So what it means is there are also different causal effects. So even if you say beta 1 shall be a causal effect, it's not yet so clear which causal effect it actually means. Shall it be the effect through all channels or only through some particular channels? As a rule of thumb, most empirical economic papers are interested in estimating some causal effect. And if there's a discussion about problems of inconsistency, or as we later see a term called endogeneity problem, it typically means that some causal effect shall be estimated. Typically, it's not so well described verbally which causal effect shall be estimated. What you typically do, then you look at the regression equation. So for example, here, if we go back to the channel variable examples, if I would include manager as an explanatory variable, then I know that I only estimate the direct causal effect that's not basically part through the channel that a higher degree makes it also more likely to become a manager. If I don't include manager, I would here estimate the complete causal effect. So basically, by looking at the regression equation and knowing that you want to estimate some causal effect, you kind of see what sort of causal effect shall be estimated here. This is not really easy when you discuss this the first time or look at this the first time. And it will be repeated again and again in this course. What is the effect that we want to estimate? Do we estimate this with our specification? What are potential problems? And basically, the more examples you have seen, the more applications, the better you can understand it. But that's basically the main problem of empirical economics. How can we estimate some particular causal effect, and what can go wrong with the specification we have, or can we at all estimate it with the data set we have? So if you find this not easy for the moment, that's completely normal. But the more we repeat it, I hope the better you understand.